Well, I want to welcome you to Gorsley Chapel. You've probably never been to Gorsley Chapel before, but if you haven't, we're a country church right on the edge of Gloucestershire and Herefordshire, and we say that we're a country church with a heart for the country. And right through this August bank holiday, we've had literally thousands of people coming to look at the flowers, coming to the ministry meetings, kids' marquee, youth marquee. It's been a tremendous weekend. The theme of this year's festival has been Jesus on life, and we've been unpacking that text in John's Gospel. The thief has come to steal and destroy, but I have come that you might have life, life in all its fullness. And our hope is that through the message that the flowers portray, and through the ministry in the marquee, and the great sense of joy and celebration, and indeed laughter during this weekend, people will have discovered that Christianity isn't boring, that it's a life-changing experience of the risen Christ, and that people have come to know that life in all its fullness. And I hope as you watch this DVD, either on your own or in a home group or with friends, that you'll not only be blessed, but you'll come back next year, maybe bring a few friends with you. God bless you. Bye-bye. The theme this year is the I Ams of Christ, looking at I am the bread of life, I am the light of the world. And I think one of my favourites is I am the bread of life, because of the lovely loaves that are there. And one of our local bakers, Daffodils in Newent, has done some of the loaves, and they're wonderful. My son is a chef, Joshua, he's 19, and he's just gone to work in a seafood restaurant in Padstow. I won't tell you who he's working for, but the first job he got, he rang me up, he said, "Dad, they've got me doing the breads." I said, "Oh, I'm down to see you." And of course, he knocked off at lunchtime, and he brought some bread, and we had sourdough bread, and we had date and walnut bread, and we had ciabatta bread, and all the breads that he made were beautiful, especially with the chips on. They were gorgeous, and there's nothing like proper bread, isn't there? There's the smell of it, there's eating it. Wherever you go in the world, whether you're Italian, French, New York, wherever you go, people eat bread. Even in the Arab countries, they have flat bread, don't they? Or India, they have naan bread. And isn't it amazing that when Jesus was talking to people of his day, he said, "I am the bread of life." And of course, he was thinking of Moses in the wilderness, of how God had supplied bread, fresh bread, each day. And he said, "I am the bread of life." In other words, if you trust me, if you feed on me, then I'm the one who will satisfy you. And when you look in our world today, people are looking to be satisfied, aren't they? They think, well, I'll be satisfied if I go on a nice holiday, or I'll be satisfied if I get a posh car, or I'll be satisfied if I trade in my wife, or, you know, people do all sorts of things. They think they're going to be better off, don't they? And yet, if we really want to be satisfied, God said, "I want to have a relationship with you through my Son, through knowing my Spirit at work in your hearts." And we can have that relationship. We come and ask God for his forgiveness, and we ask Christ to become part of our lives. And you know, if you're in a church, you'll have communion. And one of the things they do in communion is break the bread. And it's there just to remind us that Jesus, in the end, is the one. God is the one who wants to satisfy our hearts. And I wonder today, where are you finding satisfaction? You know, can I encourage you to look to Christ and find the real satisfaction that's in him? Let's have a prayer. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you that when we look into that empty tomb, we can say thank you. We can express our joy as we think that you died for us, but you also rose again, so that we can enjoy a relationship that satisfies us day by day. Help us, Lord, to keep close to you. Help us, Lord, to feed upon the bread of your word. And help us, Lord, to trust you and share your love and your gospel with others. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.